Sometimes we have two functions and we want to control the sequence at which they execute. This typically happens if one function relies on the output of another function for data, or when one function has to wait for another function to complete before doing something. One way of handling this type of function sequencing is through what's known as a callback function. And this is a traditional method for handling this type of problem, and you'll come across it all the time. The idea here is I want this printHTML callback function to output an HTML table that appends to the main in the document so we can see the results of the tip calculator in the browser over here. To do that, I need to make sure that things happen in the right order. So I want to pass my values into the tip calculator, and only when everything is done do I want to call in the new printHTML function, and then that function will output the content into the browser. This is where we'll use a callback function and call it callback. It can be called whatever you want, but I'll just call it callback because that makes it really clear what's going on. I'll expand this to the full view so you can see what's going on. So callback is here. Then at the bottom here, I'll say callback. And inside callback, I'll pass final tip. Then inside the callback, I'll pass final tip so that we're throwing the final tip object to the function in question. Now the function in question is printHTML up here, but it doesn't say printHTML anywhere so far, right? Well, what we're going to do now is pass a call to the callback from tip calculator down here. So we'll say the name of the function we want to run, which in this case is printHTML. If we have a function and we call it using the parentheses, then we are executing the function. But if we are calling a function expression without adding those parentheses, we're actually calling the entire function and passing it forward. So what's happening here is when we call printHTML without the parentheses in the end, we grab this entire constant here with the printHTML function inside it, and then we pass the entire function up into tip calculator as a value. That value, the function, gets captured in this parameter callback, and down here, we then place that entire function inside the callback and append final tip. So that way, we're effectively running printHTML inside the tip calculator function instead of sending values to it. So when I save this and go look in the browser, you see we get the output we want inside the browser. Now if I reduce this again, you can see if we pass different values here. So we have NB, NO, and NOK. Save. And we get the updated information over here. So everything is working the same way, except I'm now using a callback function. Looking at this, you may be asking an obvious question, which is, why can't I just call the function itself? I mean, I could just call printHTML down here, right? And I would get the same output. Well, we can try. So I'll say printHTML, save. Yeah, you're right. We get the same output. So why on earth would I want to do this callback thing where I pass the entire function up in and then use it? Well, there's a simple reason. There's a good chance when you set up some more complex code that you may have different callback functions you want to use for different purposes. So in this particular circumstance, we want to use the printHTML function, but there could be several different versions of the printHTML function and that you want to use them for different purposes. And by calling a callback like this, you can pass in exactly the function you want into the other function. So we're effectively saying, here is the precise function I want you to use once you're done processing your information right now, but later it could be a different function. Like I said, callbacks are a traditional way of handling this. And in modern code, we also have more modern tools like promises that can do something similar. But you'll see this pattern all the time when you work with JavaScript, where you call in a function or call back a function and then get a value. You'll also see this pattern in other types of features. For example, if you're working with a set timeout function, you are in fact working with a callback function. Or if you're working with an event listener, you're also working with a callback function. So this format of throwing a function into another function and then getting it to execute is a standard pattern you see all the time in JavaScript.